I'm Henry Cavill and I play Geralt of Rivia in Netflix's The Witcher.
This is the steel sword
that I wielded as Geralt throughout the series.
Every good monster hunter
has one. So let's get into exactly what makes a Witcher's sword. A Witcher's steel sword is intended to kill both men and monsters. Made from meteorite, which is stronger and more durable than steel, the addition of Renfri's brooch on the hilt signifies Geralt's reinforcement of his beliefs that he shouldn't get involved in the affairs of men because they always lead to his own personal pain. And Renfri's brooch, every time he draws his sword, reminds him that despite how he may be trying to achieve good, evil may be around the corner regardless. For monsters of a magical nature, that requires something a little more special. Silver, normally useless because of its malleability and how soft it is, against a monster which is magical in nature, is deadly. The majority of cases, this is what will be required. When it comes to a monster hunt or defeating a monster of a magical nature, it's always going to be a big process involved with finally getting to face this monster. And he keeps that silver sword on his faithful companion, Roach. And so every time it's needed, hopefully, everything is pre-planned. The swords themselves have no powers of their own. The true power of what a Witcher can do lies within his training. If you were to give this sword to an ordinary person, it is just a deadly and sharp weapon. But in the hands of a Witcher, it can change destiny. The design and the styling of the sword became very, very important to me after I'd wielded it for a couple of episodes. And due to the manner in which Geralt fights, the sword has to be available at any time, at any angle, and he must be able to flick it through his wrist. And if he can't do that, his fight style doesn't work. And so I asked for a redesign of the hilt here, so it was at a down angle, which would give enough space for it to pass over the wrist when I turned my wrist. There were different versions of the swords made. There was a lightweight version, which we used for most combat. A lightweight version is safer, because if I were to put a foot wrong or a strike wrong, no one gets injured. It's more of a bruise rather than a broken limb or cut skin. When we involved anything close to the face, we had rubber swords. So you're not gonna hurt someone, you're not gonna mark their face and therefore give hair and makeup a nightmare to deal with for the next few months. The last kind we had were the cut-down swords. The purpose of that is that in post, in CGI, we can cut people's limbs off using an action. So if I were to hold someone's hand here, draw the sword across and do that, their hand can still be there without me having to actually drag a piece of metal or even rubber over their exposed arm. And so instead we could just fix it in post, just have the sword come through, especially in long-lasting and very exciting fight scenes. You don't want to have to break that up. You don't want to change the motion of the body. You want to keep the body flowing through to this next movement as if it was actually happening. And so cut-down swords were incredibly useful for that. Thank you for allowing me to explain how a Witcher uses these certain tools of his trade. Be sure to check out The Witcher, now streaming on Netflix. I'm willing to wield this.